हेलो चिल्ड्रन, सो आई होप यू आर मस्ट बी फाइन, कीपिंग गुड हेल्थ एंड लिसनिंग टू योर पेरेंट्स एंड स्टडी हार्ड एट द सेम टाइम. चिल्ड्रन, इफ यू आर नॉट सीरियस विथ योर स्टडीज, प्लीज बी सीरियस बिकॉज वेरी सून योर हाफ ईयरली एग्जाम्स विल बी स्टार्टिंग. नाउ टुडे आई विल बी टीचिंग यू लेसन नंबर 10, विच इज वर्क. राइट, विच इज वर्क. वी हैव ऑल studied in you have must have studied in your smaller classes what is verb. Now what is a verb? It tells about an action. So let us, before going to the definition, let us go through these words. See these sentences. I wrote 2 letters yesterday. So how many letters? I have wrote 2 letters. So over here the verb, which is the action verb, wrote. She has failed twice. Now over here, failed is a verb, but with that, has is also a verb. She has been, it has been raining for 2 hours. So, has been raining for 2 hours is a verb. Now you must have noticed that in one first sentence there is one verb. In the second sentence there are 2 words, and in the third sentence it has, there are 3 words. 1, 2, 3. Right. So it is the thing in the verb. We have helping verbs also, right? Which supports the verb to form a sentence. And verb is one such part of speech. Which is very, very important. Without verb, we are unable to construct any sentence. So, let's see the definition. Verb. A verb is a word which expresses an action or tells something about a person or a thing. It expresses an action or tells something about a person or a thing. As over here, it is expressing road. Over here, he has failed. It is expressing about he. It has been raining for 2 hours. It has been raining is a. It is expressing about the day. Right? Now, children, we will see the kinds of verb. There are 2 kinds of verb. One is transition verb, and next is in transition verb. So first we will study what is transition verb. Before going deep into the transition verb, let us see these sentences. We played cricket. Now over here, what is verb in this sentence? Played. Played is verb in this sentence. The girls sang songs. Now what is the verb in this sentence? Sang. Next is Ranjan likes coffee. Over here, what is verb in this line? Likes. So these are verbs. So over here, played, sang, and likes are verb. But for transitive verbs, each one of them requires an object. Suppose if this is not here, we played. It is an incomplete sentence. To complete a sentence, to make the sentence meaningful, we write cricket, any game. It can be cricket, hockey, ludo, basketball, anything. So I wrote cricket over here to make it a complete sentence. We played cricket. Now it formed a complete sentence. It has an object. So cricket over here is an object. Parent, the girl sang song. The girl sang songs. So over here, which is the object? Song. Song is the object. In this sentence, Rajan likes coffee. Now, what is the object over here? Coffee. Because if I don't write over here coffee, if this is the only Rajan likes, then this means it is an incomplete sentence. To make this sentence complete and to make it meaningful, I have written coffee. So coffee, song, cricket, they are object. So in transitive verb, this transition verb, this thing, object is required to make a sentence meaningful, meaningful. Then only it is called this thing, transition verbs. Now we will see the second kind of verb. Second kind of verb is in transition verb. In transition verb. So before looking into the in transition verb, let us read these sentence. Water freezes at 0 degree. Now over here, which is verb over here, which word? Freezes. Right. She lives in the flat. She lives. So lives is a verb. Children work very hard. So in this sentence, verb is the verb. So over here, the verbs in these sentences are freezes, lives, and this thing, verb. Now, if you see the in transition verb, they do not require any object to complete the meaning. In transition verb, they do not require any object to complete the meaning. Look at over here. Zero degree Celsius or flat or very hard. They are not objects, but they are forming a sentence which we can understand. So thus we can say a verb which do not require an object to complete its meaning is called a transitive verb. So transitive verb, because it needs object. In the intransitive verb, it does not need object. Object is not required. Object is required in the transition verb to complete or to make a meaningful sentence. Now we'll see the next topic, finite verb. Now finite verb is the main verb. Finite verb is the main verb in a sentence. It has a subject and it also changes its form to show the tenses and number. According to the sentence, it changes. So, over here, for example, if I see, I study physics. Now, I study physics, it is showing the number, I is singular. Study physics matlab ki it is a present tense. It is showing the tense, the time. It is indicating, this sentence indicates the time, that is present tense. Physics. Now we studies English. Studies physics. Now we is plural. So it is also changes the number. We study physics. So that is also showing the period of time. Now next is non-finite verb. A non-finite verb does not changes its form to show the tenses or number. It does not changes its form to show the number, the same tenses or the same number. It remains the same. Like over here, He is making dinner. So the verb has not changed. Making is still there. Whether it is singular, whether it is plural. For singular we add is, and for plural we are adding verb. So over here you see the verb is the same in this sentence. So in the singular and even in the plural, the verb is the same. It has not changed. But the sentence is showing the number of people as well as the tenses. This is singular and this is plural. This is past tense. This is present tense and this is past tense. This is singular and this is plural. So, in finite, the subject changes. It has a subject and it changes the form to show tenses and number. But in non-finite, it does not change its form to show the tenses and number. Now children will see what is complement verb. Now let us, before going, looking into this complement verb, I would like you to read this sentence. The girl feels what? This thing, the girl feels happy. Since it is an incomplete verb sentence, I have put a word happy, right? So now the in this sentence, the verb is feels and happy is an object, but it is expressing, it is telling about a girl how she is feeling, right? Now look at the second sentence. She sang a song. Now she sang a song. Over here, sang is a verb, right? Is a verb, but it has an object, that is a song, right? This is an object. Right. Just now we had studied about it. So she sang a song. How beautifully. So again over here, the song has been described, which is sung by the girl beautifully. So it is which has been described beautifully. So it is expressing how sweet or melodious the song was. Now look at the third sentence. They are excited. They are excited. Now this may not be having an object. This sentence may not be having an object, but it is expressing. It is expressing the feeling about they. Right. These two sentences are transitive verb, but this sentence is intransitive verb. But yet it is describing describing the way that they are feeling excited. Right. So. What is complement verb? The verbs that are added to verb of incomplete predication to complete the meaning are known as complement. To complete the meaning of the sentence to the predicated patient sentence to make it meaningful, they are known as complement. Right. And complement verbs are generally noun, adverb or adverb. Noun, adjective and adverb. They are generally noun, adjective and adverb. All these words, if you see, this is adjective, this is adverb. Excited is what? Is adjective. So, complements are generally noun, adjective and adverb. It expresses the quality. It is expressing the quality of the subject, state or the identity of the subject or the object. Now we will study about the main verb. Now main verb is also called the auxiliary verb. Without the auxiliary verb, we are unable to construct a meaningful sentence which shows the action of the verb. It gives meaning to its to the sentence or agree with the subject, right? And it also shows the time means it indicates the tenses, like present tense, past tense and future tense. Now let us see an example over here. Alfia plays football with her friend. Now Alfia plays, which means it is the subject is talking about present tense. So it is a present tense. Now over here, Lena goes to school by bus. Goes, which means it is past tense. So these auxiliary verbs, they are also known as principal verb. They are also known as principal verb. Now children, auxiliary verb are of two kinds. Auxiliary verbs are of two kinds. First is primary auxiliary verb. In the primary auxiliary verb, words like be, do, have comes under it. With the verb, we have to add. We can add these be, do, and have. For be, on the subject and the number of person which we are using in the sentence. Suppose I say that she is hiding behind the curtain. Now over here she is a singular and is hiding. So I instead of be I use is. We are eating ice cream. Now plural is we. So for plural the primary auxiliary verb which we use is are. Right. Now for do we can use do, does and did. Do, does and did. For example, we can say that I did my homework, which shows it is indicating the time which is past. I have finished doing my homework. So I did my homework. Right. With have. The other primary auxiliary verbs are like has, have, done. You say has, have and had. Next is modal auxiliary verb. Now in modal auxiliary verb, words like will, would, shall, should, may, might, ought comes under it. And according to the sentence which expresses the subject, according to it we add the will, would, shall, should, may, might and yet. For will it shows when the sentence expresses the willingness, readiness or determination to do something, right? And would when the sentence is would when the sentence is depending upon the time period, that past tense, and it will be in the form of will. It can be changed in the form of will or the same shall. Now there are different ways to express. Like for may and may we express when the sentence expresses possibility or when the sentence is expressing permission. Might be used when the sentence is expressing possibility, right? Can be used when the sentence is expressing ability or when the sentence is expressing permission, like can I come in? You're asking for the permission, so we use that. Could is used when the sentence is expressing past ability. I could have been if I had not fallen down, slipped. I had not slipped. I could. But possibility which is past. But since she has slipped, she could not come first. Right. And could can also be used when you are seeking permission. Now children, I'll be also attaching the PDF of what we have done today. And please go through the video and also be a good child. Thank you.